There's a new winter vegetable hitting supermarket shelves across the country. You're going to see it, so look out for it. It's called caulini. It's a cross between a cauliflower and broccolini, and it's just the latest in a range of new veggies, promising to tempt our taste buds and keep us healthy. To tell us more, Sunrise nutritionist Susie Burrell is here. Hello, Susie.
Hello.
Now, we call it caulini, but in the US, they call it caulini. I don't know which is right, but is it good for us?
Oh, they're all good for us. And the good thing is we're seeing more and more of these hybrid-type vegetables, like the purple cauliflowers and the purple carrots, and there's something called kalets, which are little pieces of kale. And basically, the more of this you eat, the better. Now, this is my ultimate segment to be here talking about vegetables as a dietitian, because we know that less than one in eight Australians will consume enough vegetables on a daily basis, and yet it's the easiest thing you can do for health and weight control, and often the cheapest when you look at per kilo how much these cost and incorporating them more into our diet. So without a doubt, we all need to eat more veggies, and the brighter the colours and the more of these sort of super versions we have, the better it is for our health.
But how do they do the super versions? I've heard people say, oh no, they're genetically modified and we better not have this. Or is it just some sort of cross thing
it's
with their roots?
Yeah, or, of course, it's cross. It's similar to what people do with animals when they're mixing to make a different kind of dog,
Yeah, right.
Very similar to that. So there's no cause for concern. It's just getting different varieties, different colours, but also taking the really positive nutritional properties of some. Like, for example, the purple colour that we find in the purple carrots and the purple cauliflowers, that's indicative of how rich the nutrition is, and these are the powerful antioxidants. So the more of these we have in our food supply, the better it is for our health.
Yeah, okay, so we call these the labradoodles of the vegetable world.
Exactly, okay,
exactly. Terrific.
No need to be afraid. Yes. Enjoy and embrace.
Now, on the podium, talk us through what we've got on the podium.
Well, what someone asked me what are my top five veggies, and I think I always go for the brighter the colour, the better it is for you. So things like your bright carrots, red capsicum, beetroot, of course, broccoli, generally the dietitian's number one source of vegetables. It's an indicative of the antioxidant content and the vitamin and mineral content. So when it comes to your veggies, you want a range of different types, you want a range of different colours each day, and I try and steer my clients towards one red and orange veggie, one green, and then the purples are particularly strong as well. So they're my top five.
Okay, and when you talk about that only one in eight Australians are getting the amount of veggies that they should, how much should we have? How much is a serve?
A serve is half a cup, and we need five serves a day. So we need a minimum of 2.5 cups.
Does it matter if it's cooked or raw?
No, and I would say mix it up, because there's different nutritional properties in the cooked versus the raw. You get some great stuff from raw, but you also get some great stuff from the cooked ones. And particularly for the cooked ones, cooking them in olive oil will help to absorb the nutrition in some of the vegetables, because it helps to break down the cell wall. So don't be scared to use your extra virgin olive oil in cooking. It will add some extra nutrition and help you to absorb those key nutrients in the veggies. The other superfoods, of course, are things like the kale, because these specific groups tend to be linked to anti-cancer function in the cell. So again, you can't go past the kale and the spinach, but people often are not a big fan of kale, so juicing some of them can be a great alternative, or again, cooking them in the olive oil tends to make them taste a little bit better.
And if you juice them, you can't even taste the kale. Like, you can get your kids to eat it, drink it, because you can't taste it. The other thing that you're not necessarily aware that you are consuming vegetables, and I'm not sure whether you are, is the chips. You know, if you get vegetable chips, vegetable juices, that then say that it's packed full of goodness, is it?
100%. Now, I'd say veggie juices, if they're 100% vegetable, like the ones you can find at a boost juice or a top juice that you can create yourself, they're a great choice, particularly for kids to get some extra in. When it comes to these packet varieties, you've got to be careful. Sometimes they have a lot of extra additives to them, and often they have fruit, and that's adding the concentrated fruit sugar. So a whole vegetable juice is a great choice. But of course, veggie chips, veggie powders, they don't contain the antioxidants of the fresh vegetables.
Right.
So they're not as healthy as we may think, and a lot of them in many cases are just chips.
But are they a better alternative to chips?
I would say generally not. Generally,
really?
They're still pretty processed. They've often got a lot of salt, a lot of additives. So, yes for fresh veggies, yes for cooked veggies, yes for veggie juices. Stay clear of the processed packaged ones.
Very disappointed in you, Susie. Right. Thank you.
Thanks
very much.